Coming up on UPC, we've got the Prom Promise mock DUI information.
After another one-run loss, the Devil Rays are having the glass shatter on them. Literally. I'll have more today in sports.
And the blood drive is here today. All this and so much more is coming up on UPC, and it starts right now.
Good morning and welcome to the Wednesday, April the 29th edition of the UPC Morning Show. I'm Drew Sewell.
And I'm Amy Butler. Seniors who failed to attend homeroom on April 22nd may pick up their caps and gowns in guidance. Seniors who have yet to complete their applications for graduation or pay their grad fee may also complete these tasks in guidance. Seniors with cap and gown problems or seniors wishing to purchase an extra tassel should see Mr. Straub in room D5. Grad Night ticket holders, properly attired seniors, and their guests with tickets for Grad Night 98 should gather in front of the school on Saturday evening, May 2nd at 7:15 p.m. Coaches for the Magic Kingdom depart promptly at 8 o'clock. Seniors wishing assistance in selling or purchasing existing Grad Night 98 tickets should see Mr. Straub in room D5 before noon this Friday.
Starting next Monday, May the 4th, there will be a Bible study in J6, Ms. Bence's room. Stop by, you won't regret it. Seniors wishing assistance to sell or purchase existing Grad Night 98 tickets should see Mr. Straub in room D5 between classes. Seniors who wish to change their Grad Night guests must also see Mr. Straub. Failure to record the transfer of a Grad Night guest must also see Mr. Straub. Failure to record the transfer of a Grad Night ticket will result in that ticket being invalidated. Today's the blood drive. Claudia went out to talk to the blood people about who can't give blood today. So if you plan to give blood, listen up.
Good morning, Countryside. We're here today in the Bloodmobile in the front of our high school. And we just came to see what's going on. And we came to ask John a few questions. John, how often do you come here?
I'm pretty much every 3 months.
Every 3 months? And is it important for you to come to high schools like Countryside?
Yes, because a lot of the high schools, we get the bulk of the blood for the community, and the community, lately they've been really short because they do a lot of open heart surgeries every day.
Okay, and who basically gets benefited from these donations?
The patients and the people who need the blood, the people that actually donate blood, it's good for them too. Gives their body a chance to rebuild new blood.
Okay.
So on.
Wonderful, and we might as well take a walk and talk to some students. We're here with, your name?
Jamie Thiel.
Jamie Thiel, and why are you here?
To donate blood.
Okay, and how often do you do this?
Every 3 months.
Every 3 months, great. Do you think it's good a thing or a bad thing?
I think it's good because I think I'm helping other people who are in need.
Okay. All right, and Kelly, I know you. How are you, Kelly? Kelly's donating blood right now. How are you?
Good.
And how often do you do this?
Whenever I can.
Whenever you can is what? This is your first time, second time?
It's my second time.
Okay, and do you like doing this?
Yeah, I feel good about myself.
Okay, thank you. All right, now back to Amy and Diane.
Thanks, Claudio. Please remember to give the gift of life. Are you interested in earning school credit for a summer job? If so, you can see Ms. Ethington as soon as possible in room A3. There will be an SGA meeting for newly elected members on Wednesday, April 29th, that is today, after school in room B4. This meeting is not for the members at large yet, but all officers need to attend.
Tampa Tech Institute will be giving a $5,000 scholarship to a student that scores high on a test giving this Saturday, May the 2nd. Interested students should see Ms. Guthrie. Also, one Countryside student will receive a $1,000 scholarship without taking the test. If you're interested in Tampa Tech, please see Ms. Guthrie. Any juniors and seniors who would like to participate in the Prom Promise mock DUI demonstration, please see Officer Howard immediately so we can get things started for the demonstration.
Spanish Club, don't forget to come to Ms. Sprague's room on Thursday, April 30th so you can finish your cantinets and get the fun started. And now here's our guy Alfredo with some sports information.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, Amy and Drew. I'm Alfredo Muente with UPC Sports. The Cougars softball team opened district play with a 2-1 victory over Dunedin. Crystal Cruz allowed only two hits while hitting a triple and a single. Becky Matthews went 3-for-3, and Amy Drexler collected two hits to lead the athletes. The teams play at Clearwater tonight at 7 p.m. Anyone interested in playing football next season needs to see Coach Johns as soon as possible. Workouts have already begun every day after school. And all girls planning to attend volleyball and or basketball camp this summer, there will be a mandatory meeting on Wednesday the 28th to discuss fundraising. If you cannot attend, see Coach Sasoy in room L8. And yesterday in the eighth inning, Oakland Athletics catcher A.J. Hinch hit a fly ball foul, which hit the lower catwalk at Tropicana Field that broke the light and glass came down pouring on Rays third baseman Bobby Smith. Well, that was about the only highlight in a 4-3 loss. The Devil Rays have dropped 5 in a row and are now 11-13. Today they begin a 2-game series at the Metrodome to take on the Minnesota Twins. And that is all we have for you today in sports. Now back to Amy and Drew.
Thank you so much, Alfredo, and that's all the announcements we have for you today. We're going to leave you with some more footage from Lip Sync. Have a great day.
Lip Sync.
Don't talk, I love you!